Dignity Health is celebrating a major step in cancer treatment. For the first time, doctors were able to complete a minimally invasive cancer surgery with help from a robotic surgical platform. Joining us this morning to talk about this remarkable achievement is Dr. Smit Singla. Dr. Singla, thank you so much for being here. We appreciate it.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Explain this procedure.
So Whipple's procedure is also called as a pancreaticoduodenectomy. It's a complex surgical procedure performed for certain cancers, such as cancer of the head of the pancreas, first part of the small intestine called duodenum, certain bile duct cancers, cancers of the ampulla, and also for benign conditions sometimes like pancreatitis and certain pancreatic cysts. It's a complex procedure, because it entails a long incision. Patients tend to have longer recovery, higher risk for complications. It entails two parts. First part, we take out some organs, such as the part of the head of the pancreas, the small intestine, the gallbladder, lymph nodes, maybe portion of the stomach as well. And the second part entails reconstructing everything, joining the organs together so that the food and the digestive juices flow through the digestive system.
But how significant is it that now this is able to be done with a robotic arm?
No, certainly. traditionally, big incisions, you know, more pain, longer recovery,
sure,
more risk of complications. I think it's a major leap forward in technology that we are able to do this minimally invasive. So instead of longer incisions, we are putting in smaller incisions. To give you an idea, 1/3 of an inch. So a patient may have like 3 or 4 or 5 incisions. We are using very advanced technology, the robotic platform, to do these procedures, so less shorter stay, quicker recovery, early recovery, and back to the normal again.
And we're looking at some video of the technology. Does the time of the procedure change as well?
So when we started doing these robotic procedures, they were quite long, you know, anywhere from 6 to 8 hours.
Sure.
The traditional open Whipple's procedure can also take a longer time, but our patient, we were able to do that in less than 5 hours. So again, advanced technology, much more ergonomics, much more visualization, better precision, all these things are helping us as well as our patients as well. So time has come down.
Where do you see the future of this maybe procedure and kind of the future of robotics in medicine?
Oh, excellent. I think there is a huge potential for us, especially with advances in technology, use of AI. Just to kind of give you an example, that when we are doing these procedures, the visualization has improved tremendously. You have a high definition 3D cameras, much more precision,
sure,
much more ergonomics for surgeons, for patients, better pain control, quick recovery, shorter stay. What it means to us is as we move further and further, we can push the boundaries in the operating room, and it will really help our patients in the short term and the long term.
Are there any drawbacks?
Yes, there are. Again, these are really complex procedures,
sure,
challenging procedures. Risk of complications are higher, you know, things like pancreatic leak, bleeding, blood clots. There are short-term complications as well as long-term complications, but overall, minimally invasive surgery has been shown to have lesser complications as compared to the open procedures.
Well, it is exciting still to be the very first, so thank you so much for being here this morning. We
appreciate
it. My
pleasure. Thank you very much.
All right, Tamara, we're going to toss it back over to you. 7:19 is your time right now.
All right.